These stories about the screen out here, I spent the prisoner of war in Egypt after my plane was shut down during the war of attrition. It's the story of 1/6 of my life that I spent behind bars until my release after the open war. From the time I was a kid, I dreamed of being the best of the best, to be a pilot, to carry out the tasks, to shoot down enemy planes. I never considered the possibility that I would be there. So becoming a pilot came as a total shock. Going into action for the first time is a little bit like going to bed with someone for the first time. Suddenly realize, I've done it. I'm not a virgin anymore. As we approach the target, we pull up into a steep climb, and I don't believe what I say. It's an ambush. They are waiting for us. As I can only see the hatred in their eyes. I'm waiting to be shot. Stop. It is strange, but at moments like these, you don't feel fear because you realize that there's nothing you can do. The questions begin and I answer with lies. More questions than I am lying and traveling in this field. Suddenly the interrogator stops and he says, my friend, you are an idol and you would pay dearly for it. The blindfold and handcuffs go back on. They knock me to the ground and begin walking me over. The blows come from all directions. Kicks, clubs, punch. I want to pass away to tremble, but I can't. It seems like they have an obsessive need to humiliate me, maybe because I was so young or tall, they would make me stand up for hours on end. 12 hours, 40 hours. I wasn't allowed to move a muscle. They would attach electrodes to my genitals, smash me against the wall, make me sit down and extend my feet, and then whip out my toenails one by one, and I didn't know what to do. I feel my whole body trembling. I feel the blood rushing from my to my head. I call upon my last reserve of strength to stop the flood. I don't want the Egyptian to have the pleasure of saying goodbye. But I fail. And rivers of tears rush from my eyes and begin coming uncontrollably. And that Egyptian won't leave me, stand there watching everything. And suddenly he reaches out, pats my head, and says, in Hebrew, Amos, everything will be okay.